not as long.
And a deep rebound comes all the way back into the defensive zone.
How about if a rebound goes all the way down and goes in the goal?
That would be interesting, huh? Lehman, Urso, side-arming into the corner. And Lindsay just goes wide of the long side, in front again, and DiCarlo shot wide short side. Urso breaks it loose to DiCarlo. Crosses, shot into midsection, belly button save, GP Lindsay. Intercepted, and Grounding could have gone length of the floor in the empty net, but Tucker elected to go down floor right now. It's Lehman, over the shoulder shot, low percentage, unnecessary, 2:12 remaining. Only two wings actually crossed midcourt. Vogel breaks it loose from Orso.
That should be wing ball. Let's see how they call it. It was a nice check by Vogel, and it was in the wave stick, so it goes out of bounds, and they get it back.
And we're inside of 2 minutes. Alone in front of the score! That one could be the put away by Pat Lehman as he broke around the right wing and quickly beat Hastings before he could react. Great look, too, from Manley.
Yeah, you said it all there. That's just a great play, and boy, does this place become silent as everyone goes home. There was a great pass across. Again, finds over the shoulder. You notice he gets Hastings down on his knees, moving down. No way you're going to make that save. And it's possible to do that by looking down, letting that go, because a lot of goalies like to read eyes and think they can learn stuff from where people are going to shoot the ball according to what their eyes do. So that's a real good move. They get him down and put it up over the shoulder.
Lehman from Manley, the official call. A timeout taken on the floor by Washington. They have one remaining, and it's 18-14. Of course, the Wings had 19 goals and were outscored 20-19. And that the highest scoring game in the history of the league. I seem to remember on I-95, somewhere around Skaggsville, Maryland, a guy by the name of Tony Seaman saying, I predict a 19-14 Wings victory.
God, are you making me look great. I predicted a Wings victory. I'm not sure I had the score anywhere near right. I really thought if Brad Kotz played for the Wave tonight, it would be a real tough ball game for the Wings. And without him in there, I really felt that Philadelphia would come to play. There was just too much to play for tonight. Thank God we've been right, and they have played very well. I've been very, very impressed by the Wings' ability to shut down the spurts by the Waves. We all know that in 60 minutes of a team game, you're going to have spurts, and you got to quiet down that momentum, and they've been able to do that three different times tonight, and that's very, very impressive.
Of course, everybody but me along our crew predicted it as well. And now they're going to say, save a message for the playoffs, I guess, for Washington as the physical play begins. Greg Manley had two goals and two assists through the first several games, has three goals, two assists tonight. And with all the injuries to Krumanocker and everyone else, his role has grown. 125, and the net is empty. 6-on-5. Shot over the top. A whistler by Holtzkamp. Trying to pick a corner.
Philadelphia possession.
And a possession, Philadelphia. Clock stops at 1:20.
I believe the faraway ref said that Bilger
got a piece of that,
therefore it should be a face-off. That's interesting. I don't think Bilger ever saw the ball to get a piece of it. The only thing he got a piece of was the glass behind, and about 17 fans ducked. But we will have a face-off.
All right, let's go, fans.
You know, Larry, I really think that after watching every team now, that the only team in this league this year that is going to be able to beat the New Jersey team is the team that has been the only team to beat them this year, and that's the Philadelphia Wings. And tonight's game was so important because the Wings would, I think, much prefer to play New Jersey in the playoffs in the championship game and not in a lesser round. And if they do play him in a championship game, it's going to be at the Spectrum.
Well, Manley just got drilled around the head by, I believe, Kevin Forrester, number 32, as he had an empty net to shoot at. And Forrester just took his head off. And this is the way it looked. And thankfully, no injuries here.
You know, Manley's a tough little character. Yeah, that's certainly up in the neck. There's no doubt about that. And then Forrester looks like, what'd I do? And he's a tough little boy. There's no doubt about it.
And Philadelphia. And there's the little slap in the face, guy. 2 minutes, cross-checking.
Old
and
commercial.
We've reached the final.
An old commercial used to say, thanks, I needed that.
I don't think Greg needed that after the work he's put in tonight. And we've reached the last minute of play. This one should be in the Wings' victory column.
Spread it out, force, make them come play you. Smart, nicely done.
35 seconds on the game clock, 22 on the shot clock. And the Wings will end the regular season at 3-3. The only team to beat New Jersey. Looking for one more here in the final 20 seconds. Shot clock at 5. Trent scores. And how about that to silence the few remaining fans here as the put in by Paul French for the 19th Wings goal.
And a great pass by Henry Ciccarone. What a great pass through three sticks over to French, and French just puts it away on the offside bounce shot off Hastings. Here we see it again. What a great pass. And there is French, and puts it home. And that convinces everybody it's time to go out and start up the old car as they head for the exits.
And a super performance by Philadelphia. And here's one last opportunity for the Wave. That'll be a crease violation if they feel like calling it. With 5, 4, 3, 2 or so at the buzzer, it will not count. Nothing happens there. Kevin Bilger comes up big. John Tucker, an MVP-type performance as he puts 9 points on the board single-handedly. And some of the so-called lesser lights step up as the teams exchange handshakes at the center of the floor. The Wings have done what they came here to do, keep their hopes for second place alive. The Wings, a 19-14 victory over the Philadelphia, over the Washington Wave. Stay tuned. We'll come back with post-game highlights analysis and a preview of the playoff action, all coming up right after this.
Return of the Jedi. The next chapter in the continuing Star Wars saga. The battle for freedom rages on. The heart of a hero. The courage of a rebel. The strength of a leader. The loyalty of comrades. The power of the Force. The cunning of the enemy. Destiny revealed.
Is Darth Vader my father?
A legend fulfilled. An epic of heroes, villains, and aliens from a thousand worlds.
It's a trap!
The saga lives on. Return of the Jedi.
It will be a fine bus ride back up to Philadelphia following this victory here at the Capitol Center. The first ever road victory for the Philadelphia Wings. They do it by 5 over the Washington Wave. They do it without John Grant. They do it on the road. And they even their inaugural season at 3-3. Larry Rosen back with you with Tony Seaman. Kevin Bilger, the goaltender, the Iron Man in the nets for Philadelphia. Early on, he really made the difference for Philadelphia.
Yes, very acrobatic, good saves. He's the man who can't make a mistake because the ball goes in and it's a goal again. He was tough when he had to be tough tonight and did a brilliant job.
Now, John Tucker, the captain, the All-American out of Johns Hopkins, has played better and better with each passing game. In this contest, 9 points ties the league record of John Lehman. He did it at both ends. He did it shorthanded on the power play, did everything necessary to make sure Philadelphia left here a winner, Tony.
Absolutely. We've talked about John Tucker all year long. We said how much we like him. We're certainly his biggest fans. Tonight he showed everybody why. Here he is on a replay. You see him go in. Great shot. Hits the bounce off the hip side. John Tucker does it all.
And that, again, a shorthanded goal for John Tucker with 9 points. John Tucker on his way to, at least in our opinion, an MVP type of an award for the Philadelphia Wings. Now the playoff possibilities. Well, the Wings will not get the New Jersey Saints in the first round, but they don't know who they will get, and they don't know as yet if the game will be in Philadelphia or on the road. Either the Wave or the Thunder. Coach Seaman, who would you prefer to play?
I think the Wave. There's no doubt about that. The Thunder last week proved to be a very formidable foe for the Wings. The Wave we've beaten twice, and I think we can handle them again.
All right, we'll keep you up to date on that throughout the course of the weeks on Prism. Stay tuned. We'll let you know exactly what's going to happen in our area in terms of who the Wings play in the first round of the playoffs, but it should be the weekend of March the 7th or March the 8th. I'm Larry Rosen for Tony Seaman and our crack production crew here at the Capitol Center. Thanks for being with us. Our final score once again, the Philadelphia Wings 19, the Washington Wave 14. Thanks for being with us, and good night, everybody.